Hello, this is Gio, and you know, I have a little bit of a hobby. I like collecting comics, and after I've purchased my comics, I like keeping them in pristine condition. I bag and board them and store them in comic book boxes. And you know, I've been getting into not only the boxes with the lids, but I like these comic book drawers because you could stack them and just use the drawer for easy access. But before you can store your comics, you have to fold these boxes. And so I will show you how to fold these boxes today. So I have here a completed folded box, and here are the components of the box. And you can see they come in three different pieces. You have the inner box itself, you have an outer shell right here, and then you have like an inner shell reinforcement piece, right, just like this. And so we will start folding those right now. Okay, so we're gonna start with the inner box itself. Now, this particular brand actually comes with the inner box, comes with little spacers attached to it. Now, I've already taken out this spacer here, and you can see it just kind of popped out right here. And I will show you how this works in a little bit. But what you just wanna do is just kind of really quickly, or carefully, but I usually like to do it quickly, just kind of knock it out, just like that. I'll try to do it quick. Now, I try to do it slowly, but I usually rip some of the paper. So you just want to remove each one of these spacers from each corner. Okay, so the next thing you want to do is take your box and just flip it all the way over so you see the brown side. Now, depending on your brand, they should all kind of be labeled, the flaps. Here it's a little hard, there's little perforations that show 1, 2, and 3. Okay, so what you want to do is just kind of like knock these flaps out here. So each one is kind of loose like that. And then just fold the flap that says number 1. So you bring that up just like that and just kind of fold the flap in, just like that. And then you want to take the number 2 side and fold that up. And so this flap right here will fold on the back side of flap number 1. And then lastly, you take your number 3 flap and bring it all the way up and just kind of fold it in. And you'll see this little kind of tab here. And if you look on one side, you'll see a little hole on one side as well. And that will allow you just to kind of bring this in and pop these little tabs in that hole, and that will hold this side in place. You want to do the other side, and the other side again, you want to find your number 1 flap, bring that in, your number 2, and then bring over your number 3, fold it over, and make sure those tabs fit into your box. Just like that, and there you go. You have your box. And they're kind of same on both sides, so you could either label one or the other side. And that's your inner box, what holds the comics in place. And next comes your outer shell. Now your outer shell does have a front and back. Your back has these little handles here, and your front doesn't really have any handles at all. So you want to start with your back. So the first thing you do is just kind of open up it just like that, kind of making that little rectangular shape. So what you want to do is just bring up, kind of fold down your top and your center and bottom flaps just like that. Now both of these flaps are different, so there's a little tab that you want to take out just like this, and you'll see how that works in a second. You want to, the part with the tab, you want to fold in next, like that. And then the one with this tab that's on the outside, you just want to fold over like that. Now, so this one, you also want to bend this tab over like that, and that will go into this little slot here. Just like that. And that'll kind of leave this little tiny tab that will fold over and lock everything in place like that. Now this side of the box is going to just remain open for now. We're going to be doing the inner lining next. And the inner lining is the most plain looking of them all. It's just brown on both sides. Now if you look closely, you'll see some little bent perforations here. One's more smooth than the other. And you just want to kind of use the side that's more bent and kind of form the rectangular box just like that, kind of folding over the flap just like that. And it's just going to sit just like that. There's no connections for this. It's just going to slip into the shell. Okay, so you want to orient your outer shell correctly, and you just kind of look at the back and you see this little handle here, and the handle should be up higher, so where it's up higher, that's the top. And so you just want to flip it around. So you're going to take your inner supporting shell and just kind of slip it in here just like that. So where it's open and unattached is the top. And so you just kind of want to wiggle it up. Maybe you have to pull it open like that, kind of get it in there, and just slide the whole thing in just like that. And then the last part is just to kind of fold in these side panels like this. They're nice and tight. Make sure this is in properly. Here we go, all the way in. Fold this over just like that. There should be kind of a flatter portion like that. And then these, the upper and bottom flaps have little tabs that will sort of lock it in place. So you want to sort of make sure that those tabs get secured in their little slots here. There you go, that's the outer shell. And so lastly, you just take your inner drawer, figure out which side you want to stick in, and you just put your drawer in your shell. And there you have it. And now you could just kind of, when you want to look at comics, you just slide it out, slide it in, stack your box. Okay, so we can't forget about the little dividers that we took off the original inner box. And these are really handy, so don't discard these. What they're for is, when your box is not completely full of comics, if you just put a handful of comics here, they'll just flop on down. What these are is if when you bend this little divider here, just like that, you can just kind of fit it in place, just like that. And there you have a little space right here, which you can put your comics. And just like that, kind of put that down. And this will prevent them from falling over. As you can see, just like that. So they will not fall over. You can put several, if it's really heavy, you can put several just like that, and it just will help them not fall over. So the last thing you may want to consider purchasing, especially if you have more than one box, are these box locks, which are these box anchor locks. They kind of look like this here. I'll open them up and show you what they look like. But essentially, if you look at your box, you'll notice that there are four holes on all sides. And those are essentially designed for these box anchors. And in order to install them, the first thing you need to do, again, you kind of need to disassemble your box a little bit and remove this lining. So just kind of reverse the front flaps and remove your liner. Can do that. There you go. And do that with both boxes you want to connect. Now looking closer at these anchors, you can kind of see that each anchor kind of has these little teeth. And they're kind of shaped like this. And when they're combined like that, they sort of grab onto each other. And they'll be, you can push them together, but they won't come apart. How you install these is you take one on one side and put it through the holes, and you can kind of see the teeth coming out on one side, and then you sort of just kind of fit it, find the other side of the hole, and sort of pull this one
cleaned out a bit. There we go. Just kind of find them and then feel the other side.
And you can kind of see them poking out right there. And then you take your other one, only two hands, and then you just kind of put them together.
Holding both sides, you sort of put them together and listen. You can hear them locking together. And so there's four holes, and so you want to put all four in.
There you go, you could see them installed just like that.
Then go ahead and reinstall your liners. One around that tab there. And there you go, they're not going to pull apart. Now, to get them removed, if you're either moving or you need to move the box, the only real way to do that is maybe get a serrated knife and kind of cut in between and actually break and cut the little plastic tabs. Then you'll have to purchase some new ones and reinstall. But there you go. I hope this video helped you out, and I will see you next time. Bye-bye.